Well, enough is enough, and it's time for a change!
I have so much anger. I feel like I've been raped. In the face! Wait, stop.
At no point in your rambling were you even close to anything that could be considered a rational thought.
I guess you just discovered a new element!
Just the element of surprise.
Like a rhinestone cowboy, riding out on a horse in a star-spangled rodeo. Like a rhinestone cowboy. Welcome to the Element of Surprise. My name is Chadwick J. Suet. This is the Element of Surprise, the Mentally Irregular Podcast. You can find us at EOS, mentallyirregular.podbean.com, hosting site. All the episodes are up there. Check out the Facebook page, www.facebook.com/EOS mentally irregular. From there you can join the EOS Army. It's the group page. Yes, all of that. We got a lot of stuff to get to and not much time to get to it, so we're going to do what we do. Let's going to take that little shindig we take together every once in a while. Before I get into anything, there's one thing I want to comment on. I've been waiting to comment on this. About 2 weeks ago, I posted a picture of the poster for the original RoboCop film on my Facebook page, on my personal Facebook page. And I just put, I'm not sure if you knew this, but he's part man, part machine, and all cop. And the comment section there, thanks to EOS correspondent William Sines and my good friend Leif Husselby, who just got two new kitty cats, by the way. Congratulations, Leif. Their comments, it took on a life of its own, and so what I've done is I've screenshotted the entire comment section. I'm going to read it to you now. It starts with Leif, and he says, maybe answer this on your podcast, but does RoboCop's duck come fully loaded for her pleasure? Now, that's an autocorrect. He meant dick. I respond, I was unaware that RoboCop was equipped with a pleasure duck, but I'm excited to see where this thread goes. Leaf replies, fucking autocorrect. I reply back, Leaf Husselby, I know you meant dick, but I'm 100% on the RoboCop's pleasure duck wagon now. I want to see where this goes. To which Bill jumps in and says, might be onto something here. Ducks are known for their barbed and spined penises. If used creatively, RoboCop could have these ducks attack a bad guy, like attached to a bad guy, like a tracking beacon. Leaf goes, frankly, it's quite foul. Dun 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 dun. Rimshot. Good pun. I put, technically, Bill, it's cats you're thinking of that have. It's cats that have a barbed penis, ducks have a corkscrew penis, and I have an average penis. Bill gets back and says, Chadwick J. Suett, your intimate knowledge of fowl cock scares me. To which I reply, William Sines, what good would I be if I didn't legitimately scare my friends? I just had to get that out there because it was so entertaining to me to just, you know, how that conversation took on a life of its own. But I want to know, after hearing that conversation, I want to know your feedback. What do you think about the character of RoboCop, played by Peter Weller in 1987? What if he had, equipped with him was a duck that gives pleasure? Not even a robotic duck, just a pleasure duck. Like, he's got the one holster in it built into his robot leg where the gun comes out. What if there's, like, a cavity in his chest that just opens up and it launches a duck at you that is just, like, this duck is all types of horny and just comes down on you with its little corkscrew duck dick and just starts going to town on you. And it's like, wah, 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 wah. What are your thoughts on that? I'm on board. I want that to be one of RoboCop's lesser known but fully functional abilities. And I think that's a great way to start this episode, actually. Oh, my God. What would life be like without Leaf and William Sines to give me the ideas that they put in my head? Again, that said, this week is going to be all about Would You Rather, a game of Would You Rather. So I asked for Would You Rather questions, and you guys didn't disappoint me. So thank you for that. But before we get to that, I did notice there is something else I wanted to talk about. And that is that Walmart is going to be offering their new brand, their own Walmart brand of analog insulin for diabetics. That they say will come at a much cheaper price for patients who have no insurance or who need to pay out of pocket for the life-saving drug. So Walmart is going to be offering their own brand of insulin now, which I'm assuming is just going to be sugar water, just watered-down sugar, and, you know, with the little Walmart burst star on it. And they're also going to be offering it at Sam's Club as well, because, you know, what would Walmart be without Sam's Club is, you know, to sell things in bulk. So That's funny to me because, again, it's Walmart brand cheap insulin, which is just, I know in my heart, I know in my soul of souls that it's just going to be a little bit of sugar with a lot of water. You know, just enough for you to inject yourself with sugar water to get your fucking sugar levels up or down. Well, up. And what's scaring me, the scary part of this is, well, I mean, there's a lot of fucking scary things with this, but the real scary part for me is that Sam's Club is also going to be offering it in bulk. So, I mean, what are the? Is it just going to be like a hammock, like a pallet full of fucking, like, you know, jugs, like, you know, like those water jugs that they have at the water cooler that are like big jugs like that? Is it just going to be like a pallet of those stacked upon each other for like a certain price? It's like, oh yes, you could pay $73 for a vial at Walmart or $251 for this entire pallet of insulin, of our cheap insulin sugar water. You know, why would anybody want that? And where would they keep it? Is it going to be next to the fucking, like, 4-gallon jug of mayonnaise that they have? Is it going to be next to the 3-gallon jug of KY jelly? Or is it just going to be in between all of those? You know, and why in the fuck are they offering like, bulk insulin. You know, and I know what everyone's going to say. Oh, well, that's for if the hospitals want to pick it up cheap. Okay, well, first off, A, again, a lot of scary things here. A, if hospitals are going to Sam's Club to buy insulin for their patients, don't go to that hospital. Don't go there. Two, why the fuck are they making their own brand of cheap insulin? What the fuck is wrong with it? What, there's a lot wrong with this picture, people. I mean, based off what research I've done, there are 34 million Americans alone, just Americans, that have diabetes. So, you just want to send these people to your local Walmart and just be like, yeah, me and my wife, we were outside running around after that chicken. It done got away from us because we were all winded. Not because of the 600 pounds we is, but because of the it's our low blood sugar. So we need to get that there insulin that you guys got there. Can you give us that there sugar water? Just put it up in my veins. You know what? Fuck it. I'll just drink it. I'll just drink your sugar water. This is not something we need. And then Walmart's comments on it are fucking hysterical. They're like, we know many people with diabetes struggle to manage the financial burden of their condition, and we are focused on helping them by providing affordable solutions. What? The fuck? What? Okay, I can't make this any clearer. Walmart and Sam's Club are offering cheap insulin, their own brand of cheap insulin, which again, I know in my heart is just going to be sugar water, to people who have a rough time being diabetic because they can't afford it. This is some truly terrifying shit. You know, I mean, fuck that, you know, Bezos is going into space. Yes, I am back in space. I am Bezos. Fuck that. Walmart's offering insulin that you could just walk in and buy. You could just be in there and just be like, oh yeah, give me some of that insulin too. Yeah, well, you know, we like to Walmart to be your one-stop shopping experience. You could pick up groceries, you could grab a new bike for your kids, you could grab some chicken wire, some bird food, some cat litter, and your insulin. Oh, great, thank you, wonderful. All Walmart branded, by the way, and you can get away with all of this for under $200. No, I don't trust a life-saving drug that is a Walmart brand. If Walmart branded their own fucking, like, I don't know, like their own fucking, like, cancer-curing pill. Let's say Walmart scientists, which in and of itself is a laughable fucking comment, but let's say Walmart scientists were able to literally cure cancer. Let's say they just cured cancer and all it would take is one pill. One pill once a day for 30 days. And they're like, yeah, we'll get that cancer drug. It's Walmart brand anti-cancer pill. I would stay the fuck as far away from that as humanly possible, even if it worked, because it's a Walmart brand fucking cancer-curing pill. So why the fuck am I going to go there and be like, yes, give me some of your finest Walmart insulin, whenever I know that I could literally just dump a bag of sugar into a bowl of water or a pitcher of water and stir it up, and I pretty much made the same concoction. I could pour it into a 5-gallon bucket and make the Sam's Club version, because nobody ever fucking needs that. And I could just give it away to people for free. They'd be like, you sure this is as good as the Walmart stuff? I promise you it's better than the Walmart stuff, because I put 2 bags of sugar into my sugar water. Jesus fucking Christ. Anyway, moving on. It's time to play Would You Rather. And again, I want to thank, you know, my listeners who gave me some of their questions, as well as, you know, Bill, Leaf, the others. You guys know who you are. But we're going to start off with one that Leaf gave me. He said, would you rather put a quart of water in an enemy's gas tank or a thermite charge on their engine mounts? I don't know why he went that route, but after careful thought, I definitely would go with the thermite charge on their engine mounts, because the thermite would melt through their engine mounts, and then as they're driving along, they see the heat of the engine would ignite the thermite. And as they're driving along, the engine would just drop, literally just drop out of the vehicle. Whereas if I put water in an enemy's gas tank, it's just going to fuck up the engine, but I like the visual aesthetic of the engine just flying out as they're cruising along? Because what if they're going downhill? What if they're going downhill and the engine just comes out? They're still going to be going. The car's not going to stop. And now the engine is not there for any of the brakes to work or anything. They're just going to careen off the road somewhere. It's going to be a delightful event to view. Bill Sines hits us with the next one. Would you rather take a bath in private with Michael Jackson's decaying corpse, or would you rather do an interpretive dance at your local park explaining the origin and details of the video Two Girls, One Cup? Well, that, Bill, is a, that's a hell of a question. That's a hell of a choice there for me, but I'm going to have to go with the bathing with Michael Jackson's corpse because it's a corpse. You know, I don't want to have to explain Two Girls, One Cup to anybody ever through any format, up to and including interpretive dance. You also said that the details of the video, my dance would involve props. I don't want, no, none of that. So yeah, I'd take a private bath with Michael Jackson's corpse. I'd take video of it. I'd make it not private. I'd live stream that shit. You guys could all tune in and watch. Now, the fact that I would have Michael Jackson's decaying corpse is a whole nother situation altogether. I don't know how I'd get my hands on it, nor do I want to imagine the lengths that I would have to probably go through to do so. But, that said, I would definitely take a bath with Michael Jackson's corpse over doing an interpretive dance to detail the origins of Two Girls, One Cup. Would you rather have finger-sized nipples or nipple-sized fingers? I really had to rack my brain on this one because I'm not exactly sure. Like, I know what nipples are, but nipples come in different sizes and varieties, as do fingers. So, there are people who exist with those, like, long 70s nipples that are kind of the size of small fingers. But having nipple-sized fingers, would that just be like, am I talking about like one of those like 1970s long nipples? Because I already have fingers like that. Or are we just talking like regular, like small, like almost flat nipples? Or are we talking those big round saucer cup nipples? Because if I had fingers that were just flat, but each one was the size of like a teacup saucer, I think I'd go that route because then I could use them like little suction cups. Like the way like a tree frog does whenever it climbs on something, it'd be like, hear me climbing around things, and I just like that. So I definitely want to go with the nipple-sized fingers, but only if it were the giant teacup-sized nipple-sized fingers like I just described. Other than that, I would rather have finger-sized nipples, and I would display them at all points in time to the world. To everyone I know, at all times, you know, like I would just wear like you know how like there are those people that like they wear like in the 70s they would wear like their shirt wide open with like their chest hair. I would do that, but you'd see the shirt would be like poking because of the little nipples. It'd be like, okay, here's what I want everyone to do. Everyone listening, put your finger in your shirt, or put your hands up your shirt. Put two fingers outward. Put your two pointer fingers outward. Look down. You see that? You see what you just did with your fingers? That's what my nipples would look like at all times, and I would definitely have my shirt, like, open. So that way it would just be, like, out and the breeze would get there, and you'd catch a glimpse of my giant finger nipples. Now, I'm not sure if this is the way you were going or not, but you said finger-sized nipples, not fingers for nipples, but would they be jointed? Would my nipples be jointed like fingers? And if so, how articulate are they? Like, are they capable of gripping something? Like, could I, like, be like, oh, yeah, no, I have a pen right here, and I put a pen up underneath my nipple, and my nipple just, like, you know, wraps around it and grabs it. Like a prehensile tail, kind of. I don't know. But, yeah, I'd rather probably have the finger-sized nipples over the nipple-sized fingers, unless the nipple-sized fingers are those big teacup saucer nipples. Jesus Christ. Moving on. Would you rather go bright purple when embarrassed or sweat so much that you soak your clothes? I guess I'd rather sweat so much that I soak my clothes. Like, I mean, like, like soaked. I like as if I just got out of a pool. Like as if someone pushed me into a pool fully clothed and I got out and I'm dripping, I'm sopping wet from head to toe. I would rather sweat like that. I think that, I mean, here's the question that I have for you. Is this supposed to be done constantly? Like, am I constantly sweating like this? Because then that would suck. I would definitely go bright purple when embarrassed, because that would only happen when I'm embarrassed. But if I soak my clothes like that only when I sweat, that's fine. Yeah, I'm cool with that. But if I'm sweating constantly, no, I definitely would go bright purple. You know, you left a lot of X factors there. There's not really much else I can do with that. Would you rather see your other half in a porn video or your parents? Gotta go with the parents on this one. I've always been fascinated to find out exactly what position I was conceived in. And my mom won't answer me. She just yells at me whenever I ask. I'm like, what position was I conceived in? She's like, Chadwick, you don't ask that kind of question to your mother. So, based off that, as disgusting as it would be to watch, I'd probably have to go with my parents. Just because then I'd get a feel for what they're into, and then I'd kind of be able to put the pieces together and figure out exactly what position I was conceived in. That said, moving on. Would you rather wear someone else's dirty underwear or use their toothbrush? Oh, I'd wear somebody else's underwear in a heartbeat. That wouldn't be, that's not even a thing for me. I fucking actually think I've done that. I'm pretty sure I've done that. Now, it says dirty underwear, but, you know, I mean, what underwear are really ever clean? I'll tell you, the ones straight out of the package. After that, never fully clean again. They're not zestfully clean. They're, you know, they've been on your snooch and on your gooch, so they're not fully clean. So, I mean, I would definitely wear somebody else's dirty underwear before I'd use their toothbrush. I don't think they'd want the toothbrush back, being honest. Would you rather have a one-minute conversation with your past self or your future self? Definitely my past self. I'd kick that guy's ass into gear. I don't want my future self coming back, because if it were me, my future self would come back to tell me something. I wouldn't have a chance to get a word in. So I'd have to go back and tell my past self what the fuck's going on, so that way he knows and he can avoid some of the shit that I've been into. Maybe start this podcast about 10 years sooner. Were podcasts even a thing then? I don't know. Would you rather be constantly itchy or constantly sticky? Sticky. I'd rather be constantly sticky, because being itchy sucks, and I don't like being itchy. Nobody really likes being itchy. I mean, you know, you sit there and you scratch, you break the skin, you're constantly red with welts and sores and shit like that. That sucks. Nobody likes that. But if you're constantly sticky, it just creeps out other people. It grosses them out. You're not really so much grossed out by it yourself as they are. Like, imagine, like, you're constantly sticky. You know, like I've said many times before on this podcast, I work retail. So imagine a customer comes in, and they go and they shake my hand. I'm like, hi, well, my name's Chad. How can I help you? And, welcome. And I stick my hand out, and they shake my hand, and it's just sticky. They don't know why. They have no idea that I'm just a constantly sticky person. That I'm just naturally sticky all the time. They wouldn't know why I'm sticky. They're just going to be like, ugh. Ugh. What? Gross. Gross. And I think I'd get a lot of enjoyment out of that. I would go out of my way to shake as many hands as possible. I'd give people hugs just to be, like, sticky all over them. They'd be like, ugh. The sticky person is hugging me. Make him not. Would you rather lick someone's armpit or help someone else lick your armpit? I've had both happen. I guess it depends on the armpit. I don't really want anybody to lick my armpit so much, but it depends on the armpit that I'd be licking. Like, there's a very limited few armpits that I'd be licking, that I'd be okay with licking. So I guess I'd probably lick somebody else's armpit before I'd want my own armpit licked. Would you rather have a 10-inch long belly button that swayed to music or accordions for legs? Wow. Wow, that's a good one. Yes to all, but no. If I had to choose which one I want more, it's definitely the 10-inch long belly button that sways back and forth to music. Because I imagine it would be like that little... You remember at the end of the original, the first Guardians of the Galaxy movie, when Baby Groot starts dancing and he's still, like, in his planter and he's just swaying? It would just be like that, but it would be my belly button. My 10-inch long Audi belly button that I'm sure would just look disturbing as fuck. Just swaying back and forth to the music. And I would enjoy that so, so much. Just so, so much. Now, having accordions for legs, that would be fun. But the belly button thing is just, that's like everyone else's nightmare is my dream. You know, one man's trash is another man's treasure, and that's certainly my treasure, ladies and gentlemen. Would you rather have been born with an elephant trunk or with a giraffe neck? Oh, I'd got to go with the giraffe neck, because I'd be able to see way up high. Now, the elephant trunk would be fun. But, you know, it'd be hanging off my face. I'm imagining it'd be kind of heavy, and it would put strain on my regular neck that I already don't need. So, definitely the giraffe neck, because I'd be able to see up high over things. Giraffes' necks are really, really, really fucking strong. Also, they do that thing when they get into fights where they just whip their fucking necks around and just start bashing their necks off each other. And that would just be fun to just fucking do to people. Like, imagine I get in a fight. You know, I get into a fight, I got the elephant trunk weighing me down, I can't see straight, I get my ass kicked. I get in a fight, I got that long giraffe neck, that super strong giraffe neck. I just wham! And just giraffe neck a motherfucker in the head. They'd be like, what the fuck just happened? And I'd be like, yeah, from like 10 feet in the air. That's the way to go with that one. That is absolutely the way you go with that one. Giraffe neck all the way. 110% giraffe neck. Would you rather eat a handful of poison ivy or a handful of wasps? Definitely the poison ivy, because wasps are fucking mean. They just sting for no reason. And so they keep stinging, and I'd have to chew them. Poison ivy, I could probably just choke that down, and it would suck, but, you know, I wouldn't have to chew it so much as I would with the wasps. So, yeah, definitely eating a handful of poison ivy over a handful of wasps. Would you rather crap yourself once a year in public or once a day in private? Once a year in public, because I wouldn't be as embarrassed by that as most people out there think I should be, because I have very little shame. And it would be better to only have to deal with that once a year than daily. So, yeah, there's that. Oh, interesting one. Would you rather have vaginas in your armpit or an armpit between your legs? I'm definitely going to go with the armpit between my legs, just because that would be weird. I think it would be like a Ken doll, and I'd take pictures of it and sell them for money. Would you rather drown or burn to death? Jesus fucking Christ. Jesus Christ, yeah, who sent me this? Yeah, no, that makes sense. I'm not going to say their name, but that makes perfect sense. Probably drown. I mean, they're both going to be painful, but burn to death, I'm going to be feeling every last... No, I take that back. I'd rather burn to death, because eventually the fire is going to burn my burn off my fucking nerve endings. I won't be able to feel it anymore. So I definitely would rather burn to death. You're a sick man, by the way. Would you rather drink a cup of period blood or sperm? Sperm, easy. Moving on. Would you rather be a feminine man or a masculine woman? Well, I am a feminine man, so I'm going to go with that. Would you rather know what your pets are thinking or hear them speak out loud? Oh, talk. I want my pets to talk. I already talked to Baus like he can talk. He'll just meow, and I'm like, yes, I know Baus. Like, we have this whole Han Solo and Chewbacca thing going on where he'll be like, meow, 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 meow. And I'm like, yes, I know. What? No, nobody said that. Nobody said that. Meow, meow. No, I don't care what you think about it. Nobody said that. And we just do, I do that around the house constantly. And it's fun. I do it, like, it started out as a joke where, like, I told my son that I could understand vowels. And now I just do it all the time. So there's that. Okay. Would you rather shout all the time or whisper all the time? Whisper, because I'd get hoarse if I shouted all the time. And I have a podcast to do. Would you rather be a tree that can feel pain or a snail that would never die? Jesus. Definitely gonna go with the snail over the tree, because the tree feels pain. The snail, I'd get used to the pain after so long because I know I'd never die. So I definitely want to be the snail in that aspect. Would you rather eat a whole jar of mayonnaise or a whole tub of butter? What size tub are we talking of? Are we talking about like one of those ones you get, like those, you know, simple spread tubs that you get from like the grocery store? Or are we talking like a bathtub full of butter? Because I'd probably go with the tub of butter over the tub of mayonnaise. But I don't want to really eat either. But I think the butter over the mayonnaise depends on the size of the tub, because it says it's a jar of mayonnaise. And as disgusting as that would be, it would just be a jar, whereas if the alternative is a bathtub filled with butter, I'm going to eat the jar of mayonnaise. So it depends on the size of the tub, but I'd probably go with the jar of mayonnaise, just being honest. Would you rather pee every time you stand up or poop every time you sit down? I'd pee every time I stand up. Again, I did this whenever I talked about shitting myself. Every time I sit, I'm gonna poop. I'm not gonna sit ever. But if I pee every time I stand up, you know, it could just be a little bit. It could just be a little trink, like a little tinkle, and I'd be okay with that. Would you rather be eaten by maggots from the inside out or ants from the outside in? Maggots, out, inside out, easily. Easy question. Moving on. Would you rather be a member of the Kardashian family or a member of the Obama family? Jesus. Neither. None of the above. God damn it. It's would you rather, so I have to answer. Fuck. The Obama family, because I fucking cannot abide the Kardashians at all. And I don't want to be a member of either family, but if I had to choose the lesser of two evils, it would be the Obama family. Would you rather have diarrhea during your wedding ceremony or on your wedding night? On my wedding night, I could live with that. Would you rather have a 2-inch penis or man boobs? Probably the man boobs, because I already know what it's like to have a 2-inch penis, so that's nothing new for me. No, I'm kidding. I have a very average penis. But yeah, definitely the man boobs, because I've been skinny my whole life, so, you know, having enough weight that I have man boobs, I would be like, look at the man boobs! Look at my man boobs! Okay. Weird. Would you rather sit on a dick and eat a cake or sit on a cake and eat a dick? I'm going to sit on a dick and eat a cake, because that way at least I know I'm eating cake. It's a no-win scenario. That's a Kobayashi Maru right there. There's no win. Would you rather die quickly or slowly but not painfully? Quickly. Jesus, there's a lot. Why are so many people asking me about my death? Can I ask you guys that? What are you so obsessed with my death? Jesus. Would you rather have your brain transplanted into a robot's body or an animal's body of your choice? Oh, easily, animal body. That goes without saying. I'd like to be Bouse. I would have my brain transplanted into Baus and have Baus's brain transplanted into my body and just see how that works out for a few days. Let's see. That's it. Yeah, that's it. Oh, no, wait, one more. Would you rather drink 2 liters of piss or spend the day wearing wet socks? Okay. I'm going to spend the day wearing wet socks because that way I'm not drinking piss. You guys came up with some really weird would you rathers. I appreciate it. I really do. So, yeah, that's would you rather. Again, I thank you guys greatly. And let's see, do I have anything else to talk about? No, not really. Not really. Okay. All right. Well, thank you guys for all the would you rather questions. I appreciate it. Thank you, everyone, for listening. A special shout out to Leif Husselby and Bill Sines again for getting that ball rolling, as well as for having the fucking fantastic conversation about RoboCop's Pleasure Duck. Before I let everyone go, I'd like you to, as always, check out a couple other podcasts. Check out A Fireside Chat over there on Libsyn.com, hosted by my very good friend Ryan McCormick. Good stuff. It's kind of his audio journal. There's some ups, there's some downs. Basically just detailing what's going on in his life week to week, and it's always a good listen. Check out McSauce, the comic book podcast hosted by Ian, Paul, and Matt on Podomatic. You know, they keep up to date with all the things, all the happenings in pop culture, you know, in the world of comic book fandom. Check out Case in Point on Audio Boom, hosted by Justin Case. I don't even know, I haven't seen a new episode in a while. I don't even know if he's still doing episodes, but you can check out the ones that are already there. And that's about it. So, again, thank you guys. I appreciate everything. And without further ado, let's cue the fucking bear music.